In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a texture node-based mesh like this one. This is a 2D texture node-based material in Eevee. We can see the material appears to be 3D, but if we rotate the mesh, it will look 2D. Here are the full nodes. I was experimenting with 4 set of nodes that goes to the normal node in the middle, and they won't be used in this tutorial. The texture node-based material will work well if we connect a texture node directly to the displacement node and use cycles. I have used a mix RGB node with the noise texture node to create a primary pattern. I'll turn the selected nodes off by pressing M, and we need to activate the node wrangler add-on to use the M shortcut. This is a math multiply node, and it's being used to multiply the values of the wave texture node. This is basically how we make a 2D-based texture node-based material. In order for us to turn this mesh and the material into 3D, we must subdivide the mesh, use cycles, and change a material setting. This normal node part is good for adding a small set of details, and it's optional. The most important part is connecting a texture-based node into the displacement. We get this interesting effect if we increase the bump amount. Time to turn this mesh into full 3D. The material's displacement setting needs to be displacement and bump. We must add a lot of subdivisions to the mesh as well. This will only work with Blender Cycles renderer. The normal nodes won't do much. I'll turn off use nodes, and use a built-in denoise feature instead. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.